Hi, my name is Sebastian Matteau, and today I would like to give you a preview of the next version of Open Sesame, which will be 3.1, codenamed Jesse James. And in particular, I would like to show you the new integration with the Open Science framework that we now have in Open Sesame. Now, much of the work that I will show you in this video has actually been done by Daniel Schrij, so big thanks to him. And it has been funded largely by the Center for Open Science, so also a big shout out to them. Now, let's start with a simple attentional capture experiment that I prepared for this purpose. So here you see, continue with a recent experiment, attentionalcapture.osx. So I click on it to open it. Now, and what I want to do is link this experiment to the Open Science framework. What this means is that if I link an experiment to the Open Science framework, that every version of the experiment, so as I develop the experiment, I create different versions, and every version of this experiment will be saved, will be backed up to the Open Science framework. In addition, when you run the experiment and you collect data, the data will be automatically uploaded to the Open Science framework. So that's kind of the idea, right? So everything you do in Open Sesame is automatically synchronized to the Open Science framework, and this all happens in a very user-friendly and a pretty sweet way. I hope you will agree. Now, to log in to the Open Science framework, you click here on this icon, the login icon with the little OSF icon next to it. Log in, and it will open a browser window that allows you to log in to the Open Science framework. So I type my email address and my password, which you're not allowed to see, obviously. And I sign in. Now, the Open Science framework asks you whether you're okay with Open Sesame using your account and accessing the files on your account. So obviously you have to say yes, I allow that, right? Which is fine. Okay, click. And then you see it logs on and it shows my little photo that is associated with my account on the Open Science framework. Now, if I click on this OSF button here, you will see a few things. You will see a Show Explorer option, which if I select that, it will show basically an overview of everything that I have on the Open Science framework. So I have a project here, which is called A Very Brief History of Open Sesame, which is something that I presented at OpenCon, a conference, and I have some more stuff. And you also see that there I have a project called Attentional Capture, which I prepared for this demonstration. So every project has an OSF storage component. Basically, that the OSF storage is your virtual hard drive that you have on the Open Science framework, right? The Open Science framework is kind of like a Dropbox for scientists. It allows you to save files, and the OSF storage is where you save these files. So if I want to link my experiment to the OSF storage, to the files of the attentional capture project, I just select it, right click, and say sync experiment to this folder. Up, there we go. It will take a little while because my connection is kind of slow. There we go. And then it says the experiment has been linked to the OSF, blah, blah, blah. Okay, now, and if I now unfold it, you also see that I have a copy of my experiment actually already uploaded to the OSF. Now, I also want to save my data. Now, I ideally don't want to save my data in the same folder. I think that's kind of messy. So I say create a new folder. I say data. Okay. It will create a new folder called data. I select it and I say sync data to this folder. Okay. Data upload folder has been set to blah, blah, blah. Now, here above, you see that you can choose whether you have these two options: always upload experiment on save and always upload collected data. If you enable these, Open Sesame will automatically save your experiment and the data to the Open Science framework. If you don't enable these, Open Sesame will ask you every time whether you want to do that, right? So I think it's kind of convenient to enable them. Okay, so now we have an experiment that is saved or linked to the Open Science framework. And so basically, say, for example, I know I have an instruction screen here, and I made a, you see, instruction. It's a little typo here. If I now fix this typo, I say instructions, and I save the experiment by clicking on the save button, it will not only save the experiment locally on my hard drive, but it will also save a new version of the experiment to the Open Science framework. And it will say so, right? The experiment successfully synced to the Open Science framework. So that's pretty sweet. If I run the experiment, I click here, and I say, for example, I have to indicate the subject number. I say, okay, subject 0.csv, let's save it there, okay. Subject 0 already exists, okay, yes. So now I'm running the experiment. It's pretty short, so bear with me. It's just a typical attentional capture task of a few trials. So I do the experiment, up, tick, tick, up, tick, tick. Okay, end of block one, experiment is finished. Okay, so now I have a data file, right? A very short data file. And this data file is not only saved locally on my hard drive, but it is also saved to the Open Science Framework, as this message says here. So if I go to this OSF Explorer, you see that now in the data folder, we actually have subject 0.csv. Right, so that's really, I think, is really very convenient, very smooth. So if I actually log into the OSF, you see all the things that I do in Open Sesame are also visible on the Open Science Framework, right? So that's kind of the whole idea. So I go to osf.io, which is the website of the Open Science Framework. I log in. Okay. I don't want to save it necessarily. Here you see my attentional capture capture thing project. Okay, if I click on it, you see the OSF storage, right, where the files are. You see the experiment, you see the data file that we have here. Now also, if I click on this experiment, so if I select it, you will actually see all the old versions of this experiment, right? So if I click here on revisions, you will see that I initially uploaded the experiment, which is ID 1. Then I fixed this typo in the instructions, I saved it, and that was ID 2, right? So you can always retrieve these old files, old versions of your experiment that you have on the Open Science Framework.